Meet Dr. Wood, baddest badass custom carpenter of Southern California. All right, guys, now I got some good news and some bad news here. All right, the good news is your prize is not a used drum kit that cost $8 at the Salvation Army. What you are playing for is this.
Whoa!
There you go. It's a brand new Les Paul Studio Series Gibson guitar, and it's valued at just under $2,000. Here's the bad news. It's gonna be surrounded by the same powder that you just saw destroy this drum kit in under 10 seconds.
You can't do that.
Basically, it's gonna rain molten lava on this axe.
Oh, all right? No.
So you guys have 2 days to build and construct something to save that guitar.
First, you have to put your plan together, and that plan must be ready in 1 hour.
Understand? There's a couple of rules that you must adhere to. This is very important. First and foremost, you must not touch or mess with the method of destruction. Secondly, nothing can touch the prize until the MOD is triggered. If you mess with that or the method of destruction, it's an immediate loss. And then there's the clock, Wood. I know you're staring at it right now. You're thinking deep. That clock has 48 hours on it. Once we start that clock, there's no turning back. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. There it is. We'll see you guys in a little bit. Nice hustle, Wood. God, I hope they save that thing. But I don't think they have a shot.
No.
2/3 of the team is eager to get a running start on the project, except for the OG, Dr. Wood.
I'm not gonna run, homie. Think I'm some kind of wannabe Hollywood actor? I'm born and raised in this city, dude. I'm the real deal.
Wood. That's what we need. Lots and lots of wood.
What do you think, Doc?
I think wood.
I already got it. I already figured it out.
Okay.
What if we built the frame?
What?
And put it over top, you know what I mean?
You know we're not head scratching. I know exactly what we're gonna do.
Circulating water through this. And we've got oil drums here.
I just don't think that's...
You ever boiled water in a paper cup?
That was idiotic. He wanted to run a water cooling system through that thing to keep it cooled down. It's friggin' buffoonery.
Listen, bro, listen. I mean, this is what I do all day, every day. I'm not head scratching. I'm not trying to figure it out. I'm trying to tell you the way it needs to be.
I don't care.
Into the box.
I don't care.
The heat's going
into the box.
Right.
It's gonna make an oven out of the fireproof box. That's the only concern.
Listen, listen.
Yes.
Same program.
Okay.
Your steel should be on the thing. You should be chopping it to length. I don't give a about masterminding it. I already looked at it.
That guy's starting to bother me. He's not a tradesman.
I already looked at it. I'm really smart.
I know you are.
Really smart.
I know. I already looked
at that mark.
Yeah.
And I looked at it, and I measured, and I seen what we're gonna do.
He has felt pretty much from the beginning that he was the smartest guy in the room and that he had the answer. Dr. Wood has been a challenge. I'll put it that way. If they fill that 2 inches up with gunpowder...
Don't worry about it, bro. You're thinking too much.
Outside, Dr. Wood begins to second-guess the genius of his plan and takes another look at the method of destruction.
I see what they're scared about. They're scared about that, because it's going to shoot right up that bastard.
I can put a piece over that as long as they don't touch that steel, right?
You can't touch the method of destruction, and you can't touch the prize.
Right, but if it's gonna sag then.
The other kid, I forget his name, but what he shared with me is true, that the fire's just gonna shoot up that pipe.
Dr. Wood decides to change his box and eliminate the opening on the bottom for the square steel tube. Instead, he'll put a hole on the side to accommodate the arm that holds the guitar.
Okay. Remedy. It burns so gnarly, and it's a poof, dude. It's a poof.
How many 4,500 degree fires you've been around?
It didn't do nothing.
But it's not, you gotta understand, it's not the burn of the flame that we're worried about, it's the heat.
The heat's got to go through 3 layers.
It's redundancy. It's
yeah,
one
but
more
it,
layer
but it provides.
Protection.
I know this will hold up.
Okay.
Without that.
Oh, so you want? So you think if the cold air is in there, it won't be proof that your box holds
it's,
up?
That's not it. It's whether it's four knocks, and it's not my box. It's your box too.
Okay. Well, then the dry ice thing is yours too. Look at me and answer me and tell me what it's gonna hurt.
I pull rank on you, mother.
How do you figure? There's 3 of us here.
Right now, you're pissing me off.
Doc,
I'm not
a man team.
I'm not head scratching. I'm not trying to figure out what's gonna be good.
because I figured it out at the beginning.
You figured it out.
This
that's
guy
great.
Had some kind of a.
It out. It's
this guy had some
team.
Kind of a nightmare. So please.
You're not impressing me by that.
Okay. Be smart. Shut up. Just shut up. Leave me alone. Not concerned in the least.
Really?
300% completely not.
Concerned?
None. All that is a sheet metal. And that flame was on this thing continually.
Dr. Wood makes sure they drill the hole his way.
This thing's got to go straight in.
Yeah.
Mark it, pull it out, and drill your punk ass hole, and hook it up to that piece of
can do.
Oh. Here. Don't, you know, do it like a white man, bro.
X marks the spot.
How's that?
So that's a perfect hole, huh? You tested it?
Sure did.
Okay,
absolutely.
Good
man.
I believe you.
You're gonna love it.
Punk ass. Okay.
With little less than 3 hours to go, Dr. Wood shows up fashionably late.
Woodrow Wilson.
Give yourselves a big hand, guys. You guys have pulled it off in time. Congratulations.
Victory in hand, our elder statesman sees fit to offer an unexpected tribute.
I think that I would sing the praises of Dr. Wood from on high. The guy led his crew, who he took over on day one, and not without resistance. But the guy did it. He brought us together. There's something, I don't know what it is about him. It's kind of like he's got this whole mystique about him. Who is he? Where did he come from? He kind of just suddenly appeared. He sort of swooped down on us. And he carried us in his claws like he was a giant bird. And all of us, we were just hanging on, remember?
I remember.
We were just hanging there. We were scared, but we were flying.
Hey, you ever seen a carpenter carry a roll like this dude in his bag? Huh? Carpenter carrying a roll like that in his bag?
Coming up next, forget speed and style. This build is all about beer. Jesse and the gang transform an old-fashioned fire truck into a brewery on wheels on a world premiere episode of Monster Garage.
Come on with it. That's why I showed it to you, so somebody would come up on me.